So I've been getting a lot of questions lately about clarifying these specific steps for evidence-based supervision. And I guess some people are confusing the entire supervision protocol with behavior skills training, which is one step of the supervision routine. So let's go through the protocol for evidence-based supervision. Step one, identify desired client outcomes. This is where you explain the client's goals to the supervisee, and this is so they understand what the purpose of the programming is. Step two, the supervisor has to specify what the staff person has to do for the client to meet these goals. This includes the actual behavioral strategies that need to be learned, but also any other details that would support the client's progress, like being on time because the transition from the bus to the classroom is important. Step three, training staff to perform the necessary interventions. Now, this is where behavior skills training comes in. BST. This is its own thing. We can use it with parents or staff in the supervision protocol, but it's obviously the recommended way to teach staff new skills. And what's confusing is that BST is a multiple step process too. So yes, in the multiple step supervision process, one of the steps employs another multi-step process, behavior skills training. I hope that clarifies it. So now you've done the BST steps, you've taught the skills, the staff is now performing these skills with actual clients, which takes us to step four of evidence-based supervision, which is monitoring staff performances. So once they've learned the needed skills through the steps of BST, we now have to include ongoing monitoring to make sure that everything is going smoothly. Client is progressing, staff performing proficiently, and if they are performing proficiently and clients are improving, then that's where the best part comes in. Step five, supporting proficient staff performance. That means reinforcement. Now look, it's not just a couple of random good jobs. There's a whole way that positive feedback should be delivered. And well, I'll save that for another day, but empirically validated feedback delivery for proficient performance is what this step is all about. And it's always a good day when you get to deliver praise. Am I right? Now, a less great day is when we have to deal with step six, correcting non-proficient staff performance. Now look, sometimes people need a little support and a review of what is needed to fulfill their job tasks and, you know, some steps to help them accomplish that. And so hopefully, you know, that's all it ever is and it doesn't get too much deeper than that. But in any event, when you monitor on a regular basis, you're going to see things, and those things need feedback and a course of action if changes are needed. And now, technically, I'm done, but actually I'm not, because the continuous monitoring and feedback piece, well, it's just that. Step seven, continuously evaluating staff performance and client outcomes. So the truth is the job of a supervisor is never done. And this evaluation piece, well, that's just one of our jobs. That's never done. And I guess why we're all so dang busy all the time. Now turn off this video and go monitor your clients and your staff.